What is up, guys? Silver here, coming up back with a brand new episode of Clash of Clans. So in this episode, I'm gonna be talking about top 3 strategies for farming in Channel 7. Some of the strategies can be used for trophy boosting too. So if you're new to this channel, subscribe me and like this video. With that being said, let's get started. Guys, the first strategy that we are gonna be using is the gold bar strategy. It consists of 96 goblins, 45 archers and also 45 barbarians. So you can also change the troop compositions. I don't know what you want to. So the first thing you got to do in this strategy, look for a dead base or a base that has so much loot in his collectors. So after that you have find the base, you just use your goblins or your barbarians to destroy that collectors. And after, actually, when you use your barbarians or goblins to destroy those collectors, use your archers to support them too. I don't know why I used that king, but I don't know. So you'll use some wall breakers to go to that dark elixir side, and also there are some collectors inside, so I need them actually. So I use archers because most of the time those goblins will die because there are so many mortars going on, and mortars easily kill those goblins. And also most of the time archers and goblins are actually pretty low powerful against those mortars. So if there is a splash damage troop, try using the barbarians. And also here you can see I'm just getting some trophies if I can, and I'm gonna use my goblins then use my archers. So it is actually a pretty easy strategy, and most of the time you don't get any trophies from that strategy. But what's the point in trophies, because you're not trophy boosting, you're just doing farming, so you don't need any trophy boost. So actually this strategy works pretty well, and I can get so much loot from this strategy because this strategy costs so much little. And also when you're actually like there are collectors inside, then use some barbarians or anything that then actually when you use them, every defense will lock onto them. Then use your wall breakers, so the wall breakers will break the wall and your goblins will be able to go to the inside and take the collector. So that is the strategy, guys. This is a pretty easy strategy, and pretty actually that is one of the most liked strategies in COC right now. And gobarch is the best strategy. Most of the people just use archers and barbarians, but you gotta take some goblins too, so that's why I call it the gobar strategy. And this strategy is very cheap, so if this doesn't take so much resources of you in just train the strategy. And the second strategy that we are using is the Gihui, or whatever you call it, the gobarch or whatever. It consists of 18 giants, 1 healer, 10 wizards, wall breakers, 6 and 24 archers and 15 goblins. So the spells actually are needed in this strategy. So the spells are 2 heal spell and 1 ray spell. You can also see the everything in the screen right now. And here you can see I just found an easy base, but actually attacking in this base is a bit hard, because as you can see right here, that base is spammed with those defenses. So most of the time those type of bases are pretty hard, so you should actually take some CC troops, but that won't be a problem if you don't take those CC troops. So I actually like to kill the king, because most of the time the king will just kill our giants. So first use your king, actually first use kill the other kings that is on the enemy side, then use your giants. And actually when you use those giants, if there is no air defense that will going to kill any healer, then use your healer. As you can see, after every troop is every defense is actually locked into the giants, then use your wizards or archers to just destroy the other buildings just resource buildings, then you'll get easy troops. So I already have a video about Jaibarch explaining in Town Hall. Actually that was about the Town Hall 9, but the Jaibarch is very easy, and also this is the same strategy for every Town Hall, so you can also watch that Town Hall 9 video. But actually that has only 20 troops more, but whatever, this strategy is actually very easy, guys. So as you can see, I'm just saving some troops to just attack at the last time, so they will do the some clear up. So just think that there is a like dark elixir, and also most of the time there are some buildings like you need to kill them, but you don't have any troops. So what will you do? Use your backup troops, like that you have saved some wizards or saved some CC troops or saved like some goblins as I saved right now. And I have just some wizards in the CC troop. I mostly take giants, but I this time took some wizards. So actually when you use your heal spell, if there is an air defense that will kill the healer at you first using, then use your heal spell first, and after the giants have killed that air defense, then use your healer. And after that, what you gotta do after going a little bit, then if there's an one more air defense that the giants will take a little bit time on taking down that, then use your rage spell again. And after that, what you gotta do, surely that air defense has some done some damage to that healer, so you can also use that heal spell to heal the healer. So that's the solid strategy, guys. Watch that video of Town Hall 9. So the last strategy is the Lunia strategy. It consists of everything is in the screen: 25 balloons, 18 minions, 5 wizards, 4 archers, and 1 goblin. So you also need some spells. Here you need 2 rage spell and 1 heal spell. And actually I already have a video about explaining it only for Town Hall 7, so you can watch that video. That video is in the description and also in the cards. So as you can see, this is a very hard base actually, because the air defenses are in the inside. So I'm just gonna be showing you how to three-star these type of bases. Actually you need about four high level balloons, but you can just stop taking CC troop, because this strategy is pretty solid and you can easily use it. So the first thing you gotta do, use your balloons, then use your minions after every air defense or every defense is all locked into your balloons. Then use your rage spell. Actually you can also use 1 rage spell, but I use 2 rage spell. That won't be a very big problem, because that other air defense is just that is easy to take down. Then when they are going to the last air defense, use your heal spell, so they will not be just destroyed pretty easily, guys. So I already have a video explaining how to do this, so I'm not explaining how to do this attack pretty much, because I already have a video. Just watch that video. That video's link is in the description. So the first I didn't use the Barbarian King, because I just wanted to show you, because this strategy is pretty good, and this strategy I just wanted to show you that this strategy can actually work without the Barbarian King. So as you can see, our video is in the time to just stop the video. So if you're new to this channel, subscribe me and like this video and comment down below what is your favorite strategy and what is the highest loot you have ever get. And this strategy can be used for trophy pushing, guys. And like this video, and with that being said, peace out.